frequent malocclusion, followed by oral habits and anterior oral habits. Vice versa, for the things to be taken away from this study, this should top the list. The takeaway is from this study that there are specific periods when malocclusion can be most promptly identified in children. The first period is at about 3 years old, completion of the primary dentition. Then the second at about 7 to 9 years, when the permanent incisors and the first permanent molars have erupted. And then the third period is at about 11 to 12 years, when the premolars, second molars, and canines, that the last set of teeth, are appearing in the mouth. Children need to be screened at these ages and early treatment carried out as appropriate. Nigeria has a growing population of over 200 million. Presently, we have less than 70 orthodontists in the whole country, with the majority in the urban cities. There is urgent need to employ any orthodontic interventions to restore the smile and transform the lives of our children. So these are some of the conditions that can benefit from early treatment. Several of those cases present to our clinic, and I would like to illustrate the treatment of one of these cases. So this is patient C, an 8-year-old boy, and these are the photographs of his mouth before the treatment. And if you look at the blue line, the blue arrow, you can see that his upper teeth are biting behind the lower. The normal thing is that the upper teeth should bite in front of the lower teeth. So this is at the start of the treatment with a removable orthodontic appliance, a simple appliance. So you can see that in the patient's mouth. Inside the mouth and inside the view of the appliance. And then 5-6 months after, the treatment is completed. This is before and this is after. The smile is restored and the life is transformed. This lecture will be incomplete without talking about this fascinating topic, oral habits. You can see this young child happily talking away. And they have two nice clothes, one hand is on the head and the other one in the mouth. Digit sucking, that is thumb or finger sucking, tongue thrusting, lip sucking, pacifier use are some of the most common causes of malocclusion. Our study in children aged 7 to 10 years showed that 18.2% had an oral habit. And out of these, 3.7 were digit suckers. Tongue sucking is very common, and most of us can relate to it. It's either we ourselves have sucked, or we know a child who is sucking. Up to the age of 3 years, 2 to 3 years is considered normal. Beyond the age of 4, it becomes a problem. Why is that? Because it can have adverse effects on the teeth, on the occlusion, and on the jaws. And then the severity of that effect will depend on the frequency of the sucking, the duration, and then the intensity. In 2007, I made a presentation at the Lagos University Medical Society seminar, and it generated tremendous interest and response. Why was that so? Because a lot of people in the audience had experienced that problem, and they did not know how to deal with it. I could empathize with them because I had been in a similar situation. My own daughter was sucking. This was before my venture into orthodontics. And I was so frustrated, I felt helpless. And in retrospect, I think I tried very draconian measures. Thank God they worked for me. But the good news is that we now have various options available to help break the habit. And so one of them, the first one, with counseling and persuading the child to stop sucking. Then the second is positive reinforcement, which includes giving of rewards. Then the third one, negative reinforcement, which includes punishment, maybe withdrawal of a treat or favor from the child. Then the fourth is reminder therapy. I'm sure some of us have seen that where they put a plaster on the child's finger or thumb or put a bitter saucer. In the very older children, they will just remove the plaster. Okay? So, but the last option is the appliance therapy, that is orthodontic treatment. So I encourage parents to act early, and grandparents also put an eye on it, to act early to break the habit to prevent associated complications. I will now go on to present the treatment of a case of malocclusion, what we call an anterior bone bite, which was caused by thumb sucking. So this is an 8-year-old girl with a thumb sucking habit. And this is the malocclusion that resulted from that thumb sucking. And see, the upper and lower teeth are not linked together because of the habit. So this is at the start of the treatment of the anterior bone bite with fixed appliances, which included the tongue grip to help break the habit, the tongue grip. So this is after 2 months of appliance work. I can see that there's a significant closure of that anterior bone bite. And then after 4 months, I can see further closure of the anterior bone bite. And then 2 years after, I can see complete closure of the anterior bone bite. So this is the before, and this is after. So the smile is restored, and the life is transformed. In first years in Nigeria, orthodontic patients were predominantly children and adolescents. Presently, more adults are seeking treatment, and we see quite a large number of them coming in now. The wearing of braces is now more socially acceptable for adults, with the availability of the clear or two-colored orthodontic appliances, which include the ceramic brackets and the clear aligners. In adults that have malalignment of the jaws, the teeth are used to camouflage that jaw malalignment. Why? Because facial growth is mostly completed in an adult. However, in severe cases, this is not possible, and we have to combine orthodontic treatment with oral surgery. Overall, the good news is that age is no longer a barrier to anyone for orthodontic treatment. The smile can be restored and the life transformed, even up to the 70s and beyond. I was privileged to lead the management of a complex case in an adult. This case was made more interesting because the patient was my student. So this is him, we call him Mr. T, and his complaint was that he did not like the alignment of his teeth and the alignment of his jaws. So these are the photographs of the inside of his mouth before treatment. These are more photographs of the inside of his mouth. So I carried out the first phase of orthodontic treatment, what we call the pre-surgical orthodontic treatment, and I aligned his upper and lower teeth. After this, he decided that he would go abroad for the major oral surgery. So he traveled abroad for the surgery. So this is the surgery being done. It was done with international collaboration. You can see that his teeth, his jaws have been reset there. You can see that his upper and lower jaws have been aligned. So this is 2 weeks after the major oral surgery. He has some swelling there. So after that, he returned to Nigeria, and I carried out the second phase of orthodontic treatment, what we call the post-surgical orthodontic treatment. However, this could not be completed optimally because he suddenly had to relocate to the United Kingdom. By this time, he was already a doctor, so he had to relocate. He said he was relocating. There was nothing I could do. However, he was very satisfied with his smile. His smile was restored, and his life, this is before, and this is after. I can see him, this is before, and this is after. And this is him, about 5 weeks ago, in the United Kingdom, he sent this picture. Doesn't he look handsome? The special needs population includes individuals with Down syndrome, autism, cerebral palsy, and other genetic conditions. They have problems with swallowing, chewing, oral hygiene, health of their gums, They also have problems with control of their body movements and also general behavioral issues. Right now, an increasing number of these individuals are now seeking orthodontic care. These individuals have to contend with these challenges in addition to their malocclusion. Severe malocclusion can cause discrimination and result in negative stereotyping of these individuals. Vice Chancellor, these individuals also need improvement in the alignment of their teeth and their facial beauty, just as normal individuals. Globally, provision of dental care, including orthodontic care, is still grossly inadequate for this population. Also, globally, several studies have been carried out in the normal population, but very few on individuals with special needs. We decided to find out the magnitude of malocclusion in this population. Our study, the first in Nigeria, compared malocclusion and orthodontic treatment need in the three major groups with disabilities. It included 428 children aged 6 to 18 years in special schools in Lagos. And it included the hearing impaired, the intellectually impaired, and the physically impaired. Overall, 66% had mild malocclusion, 17% moderate, 17% severe to very severe malocclusion. However, the intellectually impaired had the most severe malocclusion and also the greatest treatment need when compared to the other two other groups. So this is a table, and if you look at that, you can see that the intellectually impaired had the highest figure here. We carried out another study with particular focus on the intellectually impaired group. And it showed that more than one third of them had severe to very severe handicapping malocclusion. And overall, they had more malocclusion than the normal Nigerian children. The reality is that most of them are unlikely to receive orthodontic care. Why? Because most of them are from the lower socioeconomic group, and also there's no provision for publicly subsidized orthodontic care. Years after this study, more of these special needs individuals are coming to our clinic. The treatment is challenging, but we continue to do our best. Going forward, God willing, I hope to devote following years to providing improved care and access for these generally neglected individuals. Papers from this study, from these studies, were presented at two major international conferences. The first African and Middle East International Association for Dental Research Federation Conference in Kuwait in 2005, and then the second at the FDI World Dental Congress in Sweden in 2008. So this is us in Kuwait back in the day, and as you know, Nigeria had the highest or largest contingent. These papers were considered as major contributions by the international community, and I got a special invite to serve as a reviewer for Special Care Dentistry, an international journal. In the course of this incredible journey, I have received several awards and honors. However, for the purpose of this lecture, only two will be mentioned. One of the major highlights of my academic career occurred in 2004. Each year, the West African College of Surgeons, of which I'm a proud fellow, holds its annual conference in the capital of the host country. In 2004, Gambia was the host country. A senior colleague encouraged me to present a paper. I did make the presentation, but little did I know I was in for a huge surprise. At the closing ceremony, the full auditorium assembly, an announcement was made. I have been given a most prestigious award, the Ethicon Prize Award, for the most outstanding young researcher. This singular event, memorable event, catapulted into the research arena. So this is a photograph of myself with American professor Otatoki Osadia at the Ethicon Award in Gambia. In 2017, at an impressive ceremony, the University of Lagos Association of Dental Students presented me with an award for my contribution to the advancement of the association. It did not end there, as the father went on to honor me by placing my photograph on the front cover of their magazine. I was really humbled and moved by their actions. These are photographs of the event, and that is the magazine. I have authored and co-authored 50 publications in both national and international peer-reviewed journals. I have replicated myself severally in the Nigerian system. I have supervised 12 dissertations. I have trained and mentored many orthodontists, some of whom are holding senior positions as members of faculty and consultants in various institutions in Nigeria, including the University of Ilorin, University of Calabar, the Lagos State University Teaching Hospital, the Nigerian Army Medical Reference Hospital, the University of Nigerian Teaching Hospital, and also in some private dental establishments. I'm a reviewer for several national and international journals. I've been an external examiner at the undergraduate level for most of the dental schools in Nigeria, including those of the University of Benin, University of Port Harcourt, University of Ibadan, and the Obafemi Awolowo University in Nigeria. I'm currently an examiner at the West African College of Surgeons. I've been a member of several committees at the departmental, faculty, college, and university levels. I'm a past president of the International Association for Dental Research, Nigeria Division. I'm a past president of the Nigerian Association of Orthodontists. I'm a former acting head of the Department of Child Dental Health. And today, I'm the inaugural lecturer. In the past minutes, I've highlighted how the different conditions of the dentofacial complex can negatively affect the beauty and overall well-being of individuals. Through my research, I've shown the great need for orthodontic treatment. I've also shown how the orthodontist, by using appropriate appliances, knowledge and skill, restores the smile, beauty and well-being, and consequently transforms the life of individuals. I have also highlighted the need for screening, detection, early treatment of malocclusion, and increased access and care for those with special needs. I present my recommendations. Government and non-governmental agencies, including well-meaning Nigerians, should assist in spearheading programs to increase awareness and also enable screening programs for early detection of malocclusion. This will lead to early treatment of those cases and help to reduce the demand for comprehensive orthodontic treatment later in life, especially as there's no commensurate increase in specialist orthodontic manpower. I also appeal to the federal government to increase funding to the universities and teaching hospitals so that more dentists can be trained in this specialty of orthodontics. Number three, the National Health Insurance Policy, as presently operated, is not providing the expected deliverables. There is a need for appropriate policies, and I hope I'm addressing those at the positions of power. We need appropriate policies and legislation for provision of subsidized care and treatment for those with very severe and handicapping malocclusion, especially those in the lower socioeconomic group and those with special needs. Number four, the dental surgery degree program is very capital intensive, both in terms of the basic equipment, that is the dental chair, and then the materials that are required perennially throughout the training. The latter tends to be a constant source of aggravation to those in authority. I appeal to the federal government and the university management to appropriately address this by provision of adequate funding. My acknowledgement. I thank the Almighty God, the Alpha and Omega, for making this special day a reality and giving me the grace to stand before you in good health. My life has been one of abundant grace, and His grace over the years has been more than sufficient for me. I have had the enormous privilege of several years of service in this great university of first choice and the nation's pride. It has been a very interesting and fulfilling journey. However, I could not have made it alone. There are so many people who supported me on this great journey. It is difficult to mention all the names, but I appreciate you all, and I am grateful. Vice Chancellor, sir, I thank you and the management of the University of Lagos for providing me the platform to excel in my chosen specialty. Your outstanding and exemplary leadership has elevated the university to its current position. I am grateful to our dynamic provost, Professor D.O.K., for providing the enabling environment for excellent scholarship. I appreciate all past provosts, Professor Tolu Olubemi, past vice chancellor, Professor Lepo Agudu, Professor Stephen Elesha, Professor Wole Atoyebi, Professor Falasha Ade Ogunshola, Professor Afolabi Leshi, for working assiduously for the growth of the College of Medicine, University of Lagos. I appreciate the Chief Medical Director, I'm sure he's watching virtually, Lagos University Teaching Hospital, Professor Chris Bode. Thank you for being a great mentor and a pillar of support over the years. Thank you for being a visionary leader and for your innovative ideas and partnerships that provide not only a very conducive clinical environment, but also improved service delivery. I appreciate our indefatigable Chairman Medical Advisory Committee, the CMAC. I can see him right there. Stand up for recognition, Professor Wasiu Larry Adeyemo. And our dynamic DCMAC. I appreciate all my teachers from Christ Church Primary School Enugu to Federal Government Girls College Kazauri. I acknowledge and appreciate all my teachers in the undergraduate days for their positive impact on my career. Professor J.O. Akiyosi, Professor S.O. Jaboda, Prof. Frank Okizo, Prof. E.S. Akpata, Prof. Musa Domi, Dr. H. Okmo, Dr. Kekere Ekun, Dr. Nathaniel Salako, and the blessed departed ones, Prof. A. M. Oko, Prof. J. O. Adenubi, Dr. Basti, and Dr. Tola Roberts. May they rest in peace. At this point, I wish to appreciate a great giant in the field of orthodontics, Professor Michael Chukwudi Isiekwe, also known as the father of orthodontics in Nigeria. He was my undergraduate teacher, postgraduate trainer and mentor. As an undergraduate student, his very alluring and brilliant lectures sparked my interest in orthodontics. This gentleman has been a strong pillar of support from my undergraduate years to my appointment as professor of orthodontics in this great university. He is the only professor to see three of his students, including myself, become professor the same day. May God continue to bless you. Amen. I also want to appreciate the former Vice Chancellor of this university, Professor Tolu Olubemi, O-O-N-N-N-O-M. He has said he will be here today, but I'm sure he's watching virtually. Thank you, sir, for being a great mentor and for the wise counsel and support over the years. I appreciate all my collaborators, especially Professor C. Onyanso, I don't know if he's here, with whom I carried out several of my works. I wish to extend my warm appreciation and thanks to the Dean, Faculty of Dental Sciences, Professor Lorote Da Costa, and members of my faculty, the Faculty of Dental Sciences. I appreciate all the cadres of staff, from the nurses, dental therapists, dental technologists, dental technicians, and all academic and non-academic staff. It has been a very interesting journey of warm relationship and cooperation with you all. And now, my departmental family, My immense thanks to members of my department, Department of Child and Child Health, you're all fully here, to all past headships and professors, to the current HOD, Professor Oluwatu Seshanu, then the very proficient and brilliant team of orthodontists, Professor Oluwatu Da Costa and Oluwatu Seshanu, Drs. Iken Naisekwe and Oninye Ume, and then the very competent pediatric dentist in the department, Professor Folake Oreduba, Dr. Somolola Orenuga, Buki Olatosi, Fumi Ashiwaju, and Dibo Aedo. My warm appreciation and thanks also goes to the very dynamic resident doctors and nurses in the department. I also want to use this opportunity to thank the inaugural committee who has worked tirelessly to make this event seamless, ably chaired by Dr. Ikenna Isekwe. Thank you all for your permission. Thank you. And then I also want to use this opportunity to thank all my friends. There are so many of you here, especially those my friends of over 42 years who are here. Doctors Ngozi Abanusi, Dr. Nneka Nnacheta, thank you for your permission. Dr. Nneka Nido, you are watching virtually. For my Wedumo, you are watching virtually. They are abroad. I wish to especially appreciate and thank the executive and members of the Nigerian Association of Orthodontists, ably led by Dr. Amy Traoro Shungusho. I don't know if you're here. Okay, I was privileged to lead the association, the president from 2014 to 2016. There are quite a number of us. Can you all stand? NAO, where are you all? Stand up for recognition, members of NAO. I appreciate all my classmates of the Federal Government Girls College, Kazauri. Many of them are watching virtually from Abuja worldwide. Many thanks to our senior prefect, SP, Mrs. Veronica Omofuma, for leading the team, and you all for keeping our platform vibrant and active. And then to my wonderful College of Medicine classmates, Medilac 7984 set. I appreciate you all. Some of you are here. Can we stand up, please? 7984 set. 7984. As I said, we have sponsored renovations and repairs in the students' hostels. We upgraded and equipped the college library with modern computer systems. More recently, we donated a complete dental chair with accessories to the faculty. And by the grace of God, we shall continue to support our alma mater. I want to especially thank the church, especially the Catholic Church, and our Archbishop. Like I said, today is our feast day, a special feast day in the Catholic Church. The Archbishop should have been here, and so many of the fathers in our church, my parish priests, because it's a special feast day, they are not here, but I know that they are with us in spirit. And I want to thank them all, and the members of my church, the Catholic Church of the Assumption, Palomo, members of the parish pastoral council who are here. I thank you all for your prayers and support. I want to especially thank Reverend Father George Ehusani, Monsignor Pascal Nwezaku, Reverend Pius Omofuma, and Monsignor Antonio Banna for your prayers and support over the years. And also wish to especially thank members of the Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International, some of you are here, for your prayers and support over the years. And now, Anambra State. As a daughter of Anambra State, I appreciate all my wonderful friends, family, and indigenous of Anambra State here present. I'm really truly grateful for your presence and your support over the years. God bless you all. And now I'm married into Ibuzo. So special thanks to all members of the Association of Ibuzo Professional Women. Quite a number. I will stand up for recognition. Association of Ibuzo Professional Women. I wish I'm the current president for your willing support. To all members of the Otu Ehulufulu Women's Society, our president is here, the president of the Otu Ehulufulu Women's Society of Ibuzo. Thank you for coming. And to all entire Ibuzo indigenous present here today, I'm extremely grateful. I thank all my in-laws of Umuadape Ibuzo Town Delta State who have been very caring and supportive. I especially appreciate my mother-in-law, blessed memory, Mrs. Baby Agatha Utomi, for warmly embracing and integrating me into the Utomi clan. I warmly appreciate all my brother and sister-in-laws. One of them is here, the representative. Oh yeah, escape to Utomi, stand up for recognition. They have all been wonderful blessings to me. My parents. I was born to Chief Godfrey Chukwuma and Mrs. Florence Ujomo Dumudu, both of blessed memory, of Enoji Village, Amobia Town, Oka Local Government Area of Anambra State. My father was a disciplinarian. I had a passion for academic excellence. My mother, on the other hand, was the proverbial virtuous woman, ever loving, compassionate, and generous to all. I'm deeply grateful to them for the firm foundation and for giving me wings to soar. They would have loved to be here to be kind. May they rest in peace. I deeply appreciate all my siblings, Delcie, Kennedy, Nneka, and Chuchu, especially my dear sister Nneka Udmodu Onaliku, who resides in London, for all this love and support over the years. And we remember with total submission to God, CY, the boy, and Njide, who have passed on. My children, you are the most wonderful, beautiful God gifts that God has blessed me with. It has been a great privilege. It has been a great privilege raising you all and this is the juggling of my academic and clinical career and a hectic social life back in the day. I thank God for you all, my blessings. Ifeoma, BSc, Mechanical Engineering, Boston University, a Master's in Digital Media, Northeastern University, PAD Junior, BSc Business Administration, Boston University, MSc Media and Communication from Atlantic University, Noni, BA Fashion Communication and Promotion, Doctor of Mothership, United Kingdom, Sammy, BSc Electrical Engineering, MSc Electrical and Computer Engineering, Doctor of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, USA, and my baby girl, Claire, Wharton Business School, University of Pennsylvania, USA. You're all excelling in your different fields. I'm so proud of you all. I love you all. In the Igbo tradition, the biggest masquerade comes half last with incredibly graceful steps and bedecked in all his glory. Many a time when I mention my name, the first response I get, are you related to? And so today, I publicly declare that Professor Pat is talking to my husband. Amazing gentleman, a God-fearing man of great integrity, courage, compassion, and outstanding intellectual and entrepreneurial capacity, but above all, an awesome father to our children. About 38 years ago, as an undergraduate at the College of Medicine, University of Lagos, you came and swept me off my feet. It has been a love unending for us since then. You are indeed an excellent husband, and you have made marriage the sweetest gift. Thank you for being the wind beneath my wings all through the years. May God continue to bless you and grant us many more years of fulfillment and joy. Vice-Chancellor, in concluding, Vice-Chancellor, sir, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, while as orthodontists, we continue to restore smiles, I encourage us all to endeavor, especially in this season, to restore the smile to those around us and consequently transform their lives. I thank you all present here and all those watching virtually for honoring me today. Thank you and God bless you all. Thank you.
The Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic and Research Professor Oluwole Fanoloni FAS, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Development Services, Professor Yotiri Adena, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Management Services, Professor Lucia Obina Fuku, the Register of the University of Lagos, Oladipo Adejeska, the Bosa, represented by Mrs. Adekunle, the University of Liberia, represented by Dr. Badamosi, the Provost College of Medicine, Professor David Kuti, Dean of the Faculty of Dental Sciences, Professor Oluwaseyi Akosa, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen of the press, I want to specially recognize our former Vice Chancellor, Professor Tolu Odubeyi. Also, the Vice Chancellor of the Utomi University, Professor Sam Kubadia, along with the Registrar then in the Utomi University, Mr. Victoria Linton. We have the former Minister Administrator of Abia State with us here. He has Vice Marshal Frank Ijoma, Ijobena here with us. We have Reverend Father Pius Omofuma, the Clergy Catholic Church of Assumption Palomo. The 79-83 cents of the Medical College, they are well recognized. Retired professors, because a day like this, some of those big masculine must come out of their island. And we have Professor Danesi here, with us, Professor Ikeke, Professor Bobby, the CMB. We have the former CMB also, Professor Oshibobo. I'm sorry if I not recognize everybody, but let me especially recognize the children of the inaugural lecturer, Ifeoma Utomi, Patrick Junior Utomi, Nani Utomi, Sami Utomi, Pierre Utomi. Well, we have to also celebrate and recognize the one that initiated the discussion 38 years ago and renewed the what we started 38 years ago with another flower today. One of us, a friend of the university, I want to say this concerning Professor Pat Utomi. Today, the inaugural lecturer has presented a refreshing lecture titled Beauty, Braces, and Being, Restoring the Smile, Transforming the Life. He took us on the journey of what beauty means to different people and the role dental arrangements play in this, either as an insecurity or confidence booster. He delved into the intricacies of orthodontics, how it has evolved over the years, and how orthodontics employ appropriate appliances, knowledge and skill in restoring smiles to people's faces by rectifying possible obstacles to their physical and emotional well-being through treatments of the dental anomaly termed malocclusion, an anomaly which causes disfigurement or impede function of a person's dental arrangement. In fact, He said something about people going to the market to now tiddle the front end. I remember when I was doing my youth service in River City, they used to do it a lot. I thought, I didn't know that they were trying to put smile on their faces. He explained that beauty of the smile referred to a smile aesthetics and associated psychological response has become a great importance because it is a major reason patients seek orthodontic care, and for orthodontists, it has become a central concentration in treatment planning. In her lecture, she intimidated us. She intimidated us with how she started a new course for orthodontics in Nigeria by conducting the first ever study in smile characteristics in Nigeria, where she and her team assessed 170 young adults aged between 18 and 25. The orthodontics extraordinary highlighted the effects increasing urbanization, modernization, and cross-cultural interaction apart in increased awareness of orthodontic problems in Nigeria. She informed us of the lead taken to make patients feel more at ease with such orthodontic appliances, such as braces. I remember she even told us that some people don't want to remove the braces, and they can change the color according to the color of the dress that they are wearing. An example of which she referred, how babies have become so aesthetic and colorful that patients now have options of matching them in their clothes or even their accessories. The lecturer concluded that there is need for screening and early treatment of malocclusion and increased access for those with specific needs. Ladies and gentlemen, having listened to the inaugural lecture, I would say that she has successfully paid her academic debt to the University of Lagos with today's excellent inaugural lecture. With immense contributions on improving our work, on behalf of the Senate of the University of Lagos, Professor of First Choice and the Nation's Pride, you are hereby discharged and acquitted. I therefore welcome you to the committee of professors that have paid their dues. Congratulations. I hereby declare this assembly closed. Thank you.
I gave voice to her. I didn't say that. I want for you, this man. Number of Christmas clothes. No Christmas clothes this year.
I'm going to go to the box. I'm going to go to the box. I'm going to go to the box.